إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Inshallah, we have the class of tafsir from Surah Al Imran, from verse 160. Surah Al Imran 160. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم، وإن يخذلكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعده، وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. وما كان للنبي أن يغل، ومن يغل يأتي بما غل يوم القيامة، ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. أفمن اتبع رضوان الله كمن باء بسخط من الله ومأواه جهنم، أفمن اتبع رضوان الله كمن باء بسخط من الله ومأواه جهنم وبئس المصير، هم درجات عند الله والله بصير بما يعملون. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في تفسير قول الله عز وجل إن ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم الآية، أي إن يمددكم الله بنصره ومعونته فلا غالب لكم، فلو اجتمع عليكم من في أقطارها وما عنده من العدد والعدد لأن الله لا مغالب له، وقد قهر العباد وأخذ بنواصيهم، فلا تتحرك دابة إلا بإذنه ولا تسكن إلا بإذنه، وإن يخذلكم ويكلكم إلى أنفسكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعده، فلا بد أن تنخذلوا ولو أعانكم جميع الخلق. وفي ضمن ذلك الأمر بالاستنصار بالله والاعتماد عليه والبراءة من الحول والقوة، ولهذا قال وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. تقديم المعمول يؤذن بالحصر، أي على الله توكلوا لا على غيره، لأنه قد علم أنه هو الناصر وحده، فالاعتماد عليه توحيد محصل للمقصود، والاعتماد على غيره شرك وغير نافع لصاحبه بل ضار. وفي هذه الآية الأمر بالتوكل على الله وحده، وأنه بحسب إيمان العبد يكون توكله. وفي هذه الآية الأمر بالتوكل على الله وحده، وأنه بحسب إيمان العبد يكون توكله. الله عز وجل سير عند آية وإن يخذلكم فما الذي ينصركم من بعد، يعني إف الله ينصركم فلا غالب لكم. If Allah helps you, none can overcome you. If Allah helps you, none can overcome you. وإن يخذلكم فمن ذا الذي ينصركم من بعد. And if he forsakes you, who is there after him that can help you? If Allah helps you, none can overcome you. And if he forsakes you, if he doesn't help you, who is there after him, after Allah, that can help you? The answer is very clear. No one. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And in Allah alone, let believers put their trust. And in Allah alone, let believers put their trust. In this verse, there is a tawheed, that the nasr, the help, the support only comes from who? From Allah. In إن ينصركم الله إن فالله يلبسيو فلا غالب لكم. غالب نكرة بساغ النفي تفيد العموم. If Allah helps you, none, whoever he may be, jinn, angels, human being, other creatures, none can overcome you. Simply because Allah is the one who controls all of those. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah helps you and assists you, no one can overcome you, no one can defeat you. وَإِنْ يَخْذُلْكُمْ. And if Allah, if he forsakes you, doesn't help you, فَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ. Who is that? Who will help you after Allah? Who is there after him that can help you? Means no one. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ. And in Allah alone, فَلْيَتَوَكَّلْ المؤمنون. Let the believers put their trust. The idol worshippers at the time of Prophet ﷺ used to believe the tawheed of al-rububiyyah. They used to affirm, يعترفون ويقرون تَوْحِيدْ الرُّبُوبِيَّة, the oneness of Allah in lordship, and that Allah exists. Not only that he subhanah is the controller, he is the owner, and he is the creator. He is the creator, the owner, the controller of all matters. Some Muslims don't know that. They think the enemy of the Messenger Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, the Quraysh, those who oppose the Messenger, killed some of his companions in Makkah, kicked them out from their land. Some Muslims think that they didn't believe the existence of Allah. Therefore, they give a wrong meaning for the kalima tawheed, la ilaha illallah. If you ask them what is la ilaha illallah, they say it means la khaliqa illallah, there's no creator other than Allah. La ilaha illallah doesn't mean there is no creator other than Allah. There is no creator other than Allah means la khaliqa illallah. Creator means khaliq, not ilah. So the idol worshiper used to believe that. Who create you? Allah. Who control all matters? Allah. One verse in Surah Yunus is enough to know this reality. This reality which is hidden from many Muslims. Even from many imams, Muslim imams. Imam of a masjid giving Friday lecture doesn't know that reality. He memorized Quran. Wallahi, he memorized Quran, he is a Quranic reciter, and he doesn't know that the idol worshippers used to affirm the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal. One of those tabligh du'at who call to the manhaj of manhaj set by that sheikh called Muhammad Ilyas. That sheikh, they say he is asleep, and in a dream he came to know the meaning of kuntum khayra ummah ukhrijat linnas. They say there is where they take the khuruj from. Going for 4 months, 3 days, 40 days. Yes, they have a way. No seeking knowledge. They take away from people learning the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. Someone who maybe never pray, they see him in the market, they say, come on, go to the masjid. Okay, Muslim, he come to the masjid. They take him backside of the masjid. They say, we have to go fi sabilillah. Give da'wah. Let we go. Okay. He go. They say, give a talk. They teach him a statement. They memorize all of them. they teach him a statement, he memorizes. Sometimes the people they go to, they go in, for instance, we say, a group from Jama'at Tabligh, for instance, come from India, or from Pakistan, for instance, or from Africa. They go to the market around the masjid. They convince someone to come to the masjid. Then after that, they want to use him to give da'wah. Their da'wah, not the da'wah of al-Islam. Tabligh da'wah. Whoever doesn't know that. Even he may get mad. Why I say this? But this is reality. Their own da'wah. Not the da'wah of the Messenger, another da'wah. So, what they say, these people don't know them. They want someone the people know, who knows their language, who they know him, to use. So what they say, one of them speaks the language. He teaches them, they teach him something to say, some statement to say. Okay. In the language the people speak. They say this, the language, the meaning of what you say is in Urdu, this. So the sheikh will give a talk. The sheikh from Urdu, from Pakistan, for instance, or Africa, will give a talk. That talk, you translate it. This person doesn't know Urdu. So he says, whatever the sheikh said, he says his own language. Because they want to, in a way, use the sheikh from Pakistan. The sheikh come from outside. On the other hand, they want to use that individual who is from the community. This one, when did he learn? People will say, wasn't he the one who was in the market a while ago? Even he was not used to pray. Now, he's not the sheikh who giving the talk. He's just translating. He's just conveying the message of the sheikh from Pakistan, for instance. That's the way. Then they take him 3 days. They take him, remove him 40 days. Then finally they take him to where the grave of the sheikh Muhammad Ilyas is, Pakistan, there for 4 months. Sometime a year. Wallahi, he doesn't know how to read. If he didn't learn before that, wallahi, they didn't teach him alphabet. They didn't teach him. I don't forget that brother who I saw him in the masjid, who I used to see him back days with a big lihya. I didn't know detail what these people were up on. Every Muslim likes someone, alhamdulillah, in the masjid. So I used to take them to where they are. Sometimes they're crying. You even cry with them. Everybody's crying. The sheikh language you don't understand. But they cry, you cry with them. Ala kulli hal. Take them. This brother, I used to like him because he used to be in salah, always salah. Sunnah also. Shorten the lihya. You like him. Worship is there. The general people, layman, Muslim, they like those people. More than they like those who seek knowledge and learning the deen, busy with ilm. Al-Muhim. This brother, after almost 8 years, I saw him in this state, in the masjid. I was very happy. I was very happy that I saw him. Are you such? He said, yes, alhamdulillah. You're doing good, alhamdulillah. You're still giving da'wah, yes. And that's by the time I came to know they don't teach the people. The ulama mentioned Sheikh Fawzan and others, they don't tabligh, don't teach people the ilm. Rather, they warn against the ilm. Wallahi, I witnessed that. They warn against. Then, so I had this in mind. The ulama say they don't teach people, they don't teach people, they don't teach tawheed. I call him, Akhi, how are you doing? Everything good? Yes, mashallah. Then I was going to know, by the way, how many books you finish? Yani, how many books? He mentioned he doesn't, he just go. There's no specific book. They read from certain books. He said, do you memorize Quran? He said, Quran, some surahs. And I was expecting this one, big sheikh. You don't memorize it? How much do you memorize? He said, some surahs in Juz Amma. And I said, some surahs in Juz Amma. Okay. Do you really know how to read? Because how come you, sheikh, Juz Amma, giving da'wah, not just any other person, you giving da'wah since how many years? Taking people to 40 days and you Juz Amma. He said, the problem, you know why? I don't know how to read it. The problem is, I don't know how to read it. Wallahi, alhamdulillah, I started with him alphabet. Alif, ba, ta, tha, jim. He couldn't differentiate between these letters. Alhamdulillah, now, alhamdulillah, is Salafi brother, alhamdulillah. So the point is, they don't teach. And even those who learn from somewhere else, who joined them, they take him away from the understanding. You find in regardless where he's from, even if he's Saudian, when he's praying, he pray on the way of the Hanafiya. The way of the Hanafiya, they pray Salah, yani the same way. So one of those tabligh who was sheikh, the meaning is sheikh, not like this person I'm talking about. He's a sheikh who was accepted from Medina University. While he was sheikh, memorized Quran, give Friday lecture. He's a real sheikh. When it comes to knowledge, he knows. He was accepted from Medina University. He graduated from Quran faculty, Kulliyat al-Quran al-Karim. He the one who used to lead. If he's in the masjid, they like people like him to lead the salah of the general masjid of the university. The Medina University has a big masjid, and every faculty has its own masjid. The general one, which the emir, when he comes, the king, when he comes to the jama'a, he pray. The ulama, they pray. The professors of the jama'a, they pray. That's he leads, because he has a nice voice. Al-Muhim. And even when he comes to Hajj, sometimes the students who know him, they say, let him lead. The Imam accepts. This brother from Tabligh, he give us a talk. This was my point. And he talking, you've been here 4 years. People already lost. 4 years. Who's going to give da'wah? We went to Europe, find people in church. People left Islam. And you are 4 years here. He keep on repeating. Until he talk about the issue of that Quraysh didn't believe the existence of Allah. He said the Quraysh didn't believe the existence of Allah. I asked this question. I normally don't ask those who are there. They know better than me. I don't remember I asked anyone who came that place question. Except that, because that one I knew him. I knew he's from Somalia. I knew him back days. So I asked him, how you say Quraysh didn't believe the existence of Allah? Allah said, وَلَا إِنْ سَأَلْتَهُ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. And if you ask, oh, the message of Allah, that means the idol worshippers, who created the heaven and the earth, they will say, surely Allah. You know what that brother said in front of the students? There were almost 115 students from the same country. He giving the talk. The university, they have that way. You from Maghrib, the student from Maghrib, you give talk, for instance. They have their own way. Al-Muhim. This brother, he said, that was just by the tongue. Meaning they didn't believe what they were saying. That when they are asking who created the heaven and the earth, they say Allah, they didn't believe that. They were just saying by the tongue, like the munafiqun. Idol worshippers were munafiqun. Abu Jahl was munafiq. How is he munafiq, Abu Jahl? Abu Jahl was hiding his disbelief. He was very proud of to be idol worshipper. He used to mock on the Messenger and the Islam. How is he Abu Jahl was munafiq, was hiding? Al-Muhim, So this is someone who memorized Quran by heart, graduate from the universities. Before he graduated, used to be Sheikh, recite Quran, saying other worshippers of the time Prophet was not believing the existence of Allah. نسأل الله السلامة والعافية ولأجل ذلك الفقه من الله عز وجل الفقه في الدين منحة ومنة من الله قد يكون المرء حافظا للقرآن مجيدا اللغة العربية حاملا للشهادات العالية غير فقيه في دين الله عز وجل حتى في التوحيد ولأجل ذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يدعو بماذا اللهم رب جبرائيل وميكائيل وإسرافيل عالم الغيب والشهادة فاطر السماوات والأرض اهدني لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. المؤمن يسأل الله أن يهديه. لا تعجب بنفسك، لا تقول أكملت عدة كتب، جالست عدة المشايخ، قد لا تفهم ولا تفقه إن لم يفتح الله عليك سبحانه وتعالى. So and Sheikh Al-Albani used to say, he say some of those, when he see those who hasten to judge the Muslims kafir, and Sheikh Albani, well, very known, give excuse to the Muslims. He used to say, even those who are Azhar University, some of them do not know the meaning of La ilaha illallah. The Sheikh used to say that. How it happened, he say La ilaha illallah, and he go to the grave of Hussein, radiallahu ta'ala, as they say. Grave of Hussein is not in Egypt, but that's what they say. They have in Egypt the grave of Hussein, they have in Somalia. They have in Iraq. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani is almost every hand span. That's what they say in their book. Every hand span. His grave. Subhanallah. Al-Muhim, how this he do this? If he understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah. So my point is, Tawheed, the idol worshippers used to believe the existence of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. That Allah exists and He is the creator, the owner, the control of everything. One ayah in the Quran is sufficient. Allah said, قُلْ مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَمْ مَنْ يَمْلِكُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ عام مما ذكر وبغير ما ذكر فسيقولون الله. So if the idol worshippers are asking ومن يدبر الأمر, who control the matters, who control the affairs, فسيقولون الله, said they will say Allah, who control the matter. Allah mentioned in his book idol worshippers when they're in the ocean in a difficult, who they used to call. فإذا ركبوا في الفلك دعوا الله وإذا غشيهم موج كالظلل دعوا الله. When the waves cover them like the clouds, who they call? Allah said Allah. Here is a question I usually ask to refute that tablighi and the like of him who say they were not believing Allah, they were just saying by the tongue. Someone who is in the ocean, see the waves are approaching him, the ship is about to flip, he called Allah. That person, does he in that situation call to someone he doesn't believe his existence? Does that happen? Logically, it's impossible. He need help, he need assistance. He's in a danger. He needs someone to save him. He called Allah, da'awullah only. Then this person, they didn't believe the existence of Allah. Not only they believe that Allah subhanahu exists, rather that Allah hears them, that Allah is merciful, that Allah answers the call, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala able everything, that Allah azza wa jalla is knowledge, power with them. They believe all this. So, this tawheed, al-rububiyyah, the belief, the existence of Allah, And that he is the creator, al-khaliq. He is the al-malik, the owner. He is the mudabbir, the controller. Is called tawheed al-rububiyyah. The oneness of Allah in lordship. As I said, some imams don't know that. Here in Georgia, you think we're only talking about in Africa? Here in Georgia, I mentioned before, someone came to me to the masjid, the old masjid tawheed, other. He said he want to invite me to participate a conference they have in a masjid here in Georgia. I say, who are you? He said, he's the sheikh of the masjid. Then we sit with me and I have a question. Because I know that masjid, they don't teach tawheed. They don't teach tawheed. So I wanted to share with him advice that they should focus on in their conference. Who they gather a lot of people. They need to teach people this issue. No vote and we and we and we. Leave those things. Teach people tawheed. Don't teach people yourself. Teach people that Allah Azza wa Jal and His Tawheed, His Deen, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, to worship their Lord. Not to praise yourself, to connect it to yourself. Connect them to their Lord, to Allah, to worship Allah, teach Tawheed. They said, so I said, I have a question. The other worshippers at the time of Prophet Sallam, did you hear them, Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab? He said, Abu Lahab, tabbat yada abi lahab wa tab, recite the ayah. I said, did they used to believe the existence of Allah? He said, no, they didn't believe the existence of Allah. Because if they would have believed, they would have worshipped Allah. I don't forget this, because from the time he said that, I'm keeping repeating in many occasions. So I memorize it. Yes, in different messages, I mentioned this. He said they were not believing the existence of Allah. Because if they would have believed, they would have worshipped Allah. And here you find that both things is wrong. They used to exist, believe the existence of Allah, and they used to worship Allah, but not upon Tawheed. This is from worshipping Allah. In the ocean, they call only Allah. This is a worship of Allah. Da'awullah. It's the same thing Allah commands us. فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Other worship used to do in the ocean. فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا دَعَوُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. How you say they want to use to worship Allah? Dua is the biggest. الدُعَاء هُوَ الْعِبَادَ. So they used to worship Allah, but with shirk. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. They mix the believing, the existence of Allah, calling him with calling others with him. So this is very important. Tawheed al-rububiyyah, believing the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his lordship. Second part of Tawheed. This is where idol worship is rejected. Because these people, they have confused. They say, how they used to believe the existence of Allah, and Allah said, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Why they refuse to say La ilaha illallah? Why they rejected La ilaha illallah if they used to believe the existence of Allah? Allah mentioned in Quran that Prophet Muhammad and his companions, they were kicked out from their land because they say Rabbun Allah. الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارٍ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ إِلَّا أَنْ يَقُولُوا Rabbun Allah. So they say if they used to believe Allah, how? They rejected to say La ilaha illallah. The answer is because La ilaha illallah means worship Allah alone. And they rejected to single out Allah in worship. Yes, they do worship Allah, but they say they have to share, they have to worship others with Allah to be their intercessors, shufa'a, to get them nearer to Allah, to take them as means and connection to Allah. And that's what's against Islam. العبادة اعبد الله وحده لا شريك له. Don't go through messenger, through saint, through anyone when it comes to worshiping. قل إنما أدعو ربي قل الله أعبد. So they used to call other than Allah. Why are you calling other than Allah? Why are you calling the angels? Why are you calling the jinn? Why are you calling the saints? Oh Quraysh. They say those are our intercessors with Allah. هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله. They close to Allah. By doing calling them, we get what we want from Allah Azza wa Jal. نعم وهذا باطل and that's not true. So توحيد العبادة is to worship Allah alone. Single out Allah in worship. Single out Allah in worship. How many people, how many imams? Today when they make dua, they call Hussein, Ya Ali, Ya Sheikh Jailani, Ya Wali Allah, Ya Awliya Allah, Madad, Ya Rasul Allah. Yeah, that's what they're doing it. Ya Sheikh Tijani, Ya Sheikh Marghani, Ya Sheikh Fulan, Sheikh Furan. Every country they have their own sheikhs to call. Rather, in some Muslim country, every tribe have their own sheikh to call. حقيقةً. Rather, in some area, they call when their animal is taken by wolf, there is a sheikh they call. When they need rain, there is another one they call. هذا حق يا أخي. When they fear the enemy, their enemy, there is another sheikh they call. And most likely, there is one who control Sheikh Jailani, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani. قطب الأقطاب. He's the one who overwatched them. سبحان الله. لا يا أخي. Don't call other than Allah. قل إنما أدعو ربي. هؤلاء ليس بأيديهم شيء. ليس بيدهم شيء. بل الأمر كله لله. So in this ayah Allah said. So those idol worshipers, that's what I mentioned. They used to believe the Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Allah is the creator, the owner, the controller. If they believe that, that belief used to be used to take them to the Tawheed al-Ibadah, to single out Allah in worship. The ulama yaqulun, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah min adillati Tawheed al-Ibadah. The Tawheed of Rububiyyah, believing the oneness of Allah in lordship, is from the proof of worshiping Allah alone. So Allah said, قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ شُرَكَاءَكُمْ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَرُونِ مَاذَا خَلَقُوا مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. لا. نعم. نظر آية. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. سورة زمر. قُلْ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ هل هن كاشفات ضر أو أرادني برحمة هل هن ممسكات رحمتي. They will say no. قل حسبي الله عليه يتوكل المتوكل. This ayah reminded me that إن ينصركم الله فلا غالب لكم وإن يخذلكم فماذا الذي ينصركم من بعد وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. Almost the meaning the same but different ayat and different surah in different way. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his messenger to ask the idol worship. قُلْ أَرَيْتُمْ إِنْ شُرَكَاءَكُمْ لِتَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ أَرَادَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ ضُرِّهِ. If Allah wants harm for me, هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ ضُرِّهِ. To those you worship beside Allah, remove Allah has harm from me? They will say no. If Allah wants harm for me, can those you call beside him protect that harm from me? They say no. أو أرادني برحمة هل هن ممسكات رحمتي. If Allah wants mercy for me, can they withhold his mercy from me? They say no. So if Allah wants harm for them, their idol worship cannot prevent them from Allah. If Allah wants rahmah for them, their idol worshippers, their worship idols cannot withhold it. If this is the case, what is their benefit then? قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ. قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ. Say, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ كَافِينِ اللَّهِ. Allah suffices me then. If Allah Azza wa Jal wants rahmah for me, mercy for me, if they cannot stop it, Allah wants to punishment for me, they cannot defend him from me, then why am I going to them? Why am I wasting my time? حسبي الله عليه يتوكل المتوكل. To him alone, those who rely on, those who put trust on someone should put trust on him. Allah. In this ayah, Allah said, إِن يَنْصُرْكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. If Allah helps you, none can overcome you. وَإِن يَخْذُلْكُمْ فَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَنْصُرُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And if he forsakes you, meaning he doesn't help you, who is there after him that can help you? Nobody. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ. And on Allah alone, فَلِيَتَوَكَ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. Let believers put their trust. Put their trust. The more someone rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and put his trust in Allah, deep in his heart, the more he is a believer. كلما ازداد توكل المرء على ربه كلما كان إيمانه أقوى. قال الشيخ سعد رحمه الله في هذا وفي هذه الآية الأمر بالتوكل على الله وحده وأنه بحسب إيمان العبد يكون توكله. Based on the iman of the person, his reliance on Allah is going to be. If your iman is strong, your reliance on Allah will be strong. If your belief is weak, your reliance on Allah is weak. You attach to the worldly life. You scare your manager. He kick you out from the job. You scare from your wife. You scare from this one. You scare from everyone. لأنك ما توكلت على الله. You didn't depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you should. But if you depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I remember there was one of the brothers, he was not used to pray, used to do smoke in the market, civil engineer. Alhamdulillah got him. He had accident and with his skills, when he's somewhere on the air, he made vow, if Allah saves him and his children and wife, that he will be upright. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved them. Even though the car is totally lost. And this happened a lot. People's car totally lost. You cannot see how the car is crashed. Person, even they bring him out in a difficult way, but yet nothing touched the person. Very healthy. Next day he's driving. He didn't go to a doctor. Car is totally lost. So this is the same thing. So then, alhamdulillah, Allah wanted good for him. He made tawbah. And mashallah, upright. Then he told me the difference between his peace of mind, his braveness, his between the time he was not practicing, used to eat what they call, he used to smoke this, no praying. He told me, he said, Ya Akhi, before he make tawbah, he used to scare everyone of his boss. Everyone he scared. They're going to fire you. When they're going to fire you. He said, now they scare me. Wallahi, he said, now they scare me, he said. This is the way he said it. He said, I don't know who is there. Is he a boss or is someone else? He said, to me it's the same. Nothing. And they even begged me to make me promotion. I said, I don't want a promotion. Do you see that? He said, I knew, he said, that by going back to Allah, you get even reliance on Allah. You become brave because you come to know it is Allah subhanahu who controls your life. It's Allah who controls your provision. It's Allah who controls all your matters. No one but Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So if this manager kick you out, it's not the manager. Allah made a cause. You don't take the wrong means. Do the job. Fulfill your covenant with the company. Don't lay back and cheat the company and you say Qadar Allah, then no. Fulfill your word. Attend time on time. Do the job. Be sincere. But with that they say we love you lay out. It's not them. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who decree that. And Allah has hikmah. Don't say it's the bad manager. Manager is just a means. The bad man is just a means. Otherwise it's Allah who decides. Subhanahu wa ta'ala decree before that. So al-muhim, so the more someone rely on Allah, he has, someone is a believer, he has iman, sound iman, the more he relies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He put his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the more he has peace of mind. And the more he is not shaken with every trial. La, is the more he is firm. Because he knows it's only his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of everyone, who control his life, who control his death, who control his mar. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in next ayah 161, وَمَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيٍ أَنْ يَغُلْ وَمَنْ يَغُلُ يَأْتِ بِمَا غَلَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسِ مَا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. يقول الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل وما كان للنبي أن يغل. الغلول هو الكتمان من الغنيمة والخيانة في كل مال يتولاه الإنسان. الغلول هو الكتمان من الغنيمة والخيانة في كل مال يتولاه الإنسان وهو محرم إجماعا بل هو من الكبائر كما تدل عليه هذه الآية الكريمة وغيرها من النصوص. فأخبر الله تعالى أنه ما ينبغي ولا يليق بنبي أن يغل، لأن الغلول كما علمت من أعظم الذنوب وأشر العيوب، وقد صان الله تعالى أنبياءه عن كل ما يدنسهم ويقدح فيهم وجعلهم أفضل العالمين أخلاقا وأطهرهم نفوسا وأزكاهم وأطيبهم ونزههم عن كل عيب وجعلهم محل رسالته ومعدن حكمته. الله أعلم حيث يجعل رسالته. فمجرد علم العبد بالواحد منهم يجزم بسلامته من كل أمر يقدح فيه، ولا يحتاج إلى دليل على ما قيل فيهم من أعدائهم، لأن معرفته بنبوتهم مستلزم لدفع ذلك، ولذلك أتى بصيغة يمتنع معها وجود الفعل منهم فقال وما كان النبي أن يغل، أي يمتنع ذلك ويستحيل على من اختارهم الله لنبوته. وما كان النبي أن يغل، أي يمتنع ذلك ويستحيل على من اختارهم الله لنبوته، أي يعني أن يغل، أي أن يخون. ثم ذكر الوعيد على من غل فقال ومن يغل يأتي بما غل يوم القيامة، أي يأتي به حامله على ظهره حيوانا كان أو متاعا أو غير ذلك ليعذب به يوم القيامة. ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت، الغال وغيره كل يوفى أجره ووزره على مقدار كسبه. نعم، كل يوفى أجره، بارك الله فيك. نعم، كل يوفى أجره، مفعول ثاني، أحسنت. كل يوفى أجره ووزره على مقدار كسبه وهم لا يظلمون، أي لا يزاد في سيئاتهم ولا يهضمون شيئا من حسناتهم. وتأمل حسن هذا الاحتراز في هذه الآية الكريمة. لما ذكر عقوبة الغال وأنه يأتي يوم القيامة بما غله، ولما أراد أن يذكر توفيته وجزاءه وكان الاقتصار على الغالي يوهم بالمفهوم أن غيره من أنواع العاملين قد لا يوفون، أتى بلفظ عام جامع له ولغيره، أفمن اتبع رضوان الله كمن باء بسخط من الله ومأواه جهنم وبئس المصير. The next ayah, verse 161, Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيِّ أَنْ يَغُلَّ. It is not for any prophet to take illegally a part of the booty. It is not for any prophet to take the al-ghulul, a part of the booty, in a hidden way, to cheat. And whosoever, وَمَنْ يَأْتِ وَمَنْ يَغْلُلْ يَأْتِ بِمَا غَلَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And whosoever deceives his companions as regards the booty, He shall bring forth on the day of resurrection. يأتي يوم القيامة. يأتي بما غلى يوم القيامة. ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. And whoever deceives his companions as regards the booty, he shall bring forth on the day of resurrection that which he took illegally. Then every person shall be paid in full what he has earned, and they shall not be dealt with unjustly. In this ayah, Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ لِمِنْ أَنْ يَقُلُ. It's not suitable. It doesn't fit a prophet to make ghulul, to have the ghulul, to do ghulul. Means to steal or to deceive the booty, the ghanima. ما كان لبين أن يقول إن لا يمكن أن يحصل من النبي الغلول. It is impossible that a prophet of Allah deceives the booty. This is not a character of a prophet. As Allah said in another ayah, ما كان لبشر أن يؤتيه الله الكتاب والحكم والنبوة ثم يقول للناس كونوا عبادا لي من دون الله. In another ayah, it's not suitable for a prophet. It's impossible. A prophet says to the people, worship me beside Allah. This ayah comes to that form, ما كان لنبي, means يمتنع. It's impossible. It's not going to happen that a prophet steals, a prophet deceives. It's not going to happen. That could have been possible, Allah wouldn't choose him. Allah wouldn't choose, subhanahu wa ta'ala, someone who deceiving. Ta'ala Allahu an dhalik uluwan kabira. Wallahi al-mathul a'la. Think about if you would have a company and you want to hire and you want a company to make a progress, do you hire somebody who deceive you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا كَانَ لِنَبِيٍ أَنْ يَغُلْ. It is not for any prophet to make ghulul, means to deceive or to cheat, to deceive the booty. It's not suitable for a prophet. Prophet is not doing that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he mentioned in his Quran, he chooses whoever he taking him as a messenger. Allah doesn't make a messenger everybody. Allah yastafi min al-mala'ikati rusulan wa mina an-nas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't send every angel. Nor Allah does he send every human being. Allah he sends to carry his message to his creation those he chose them. Istifa. Allah who knows everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not choosing a messenger, as someone who will say to the people, worship me beside Allah. Allah is not choosing someone who will deceive people. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيٍ أَنْ يَغُلْ. وَمَنْ يَغْلُلْ يَأْتِ بِمَا غَلَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And whoever deceives the booty, shall bring forth on the day of resurrection that which he took, that which he deceived. Whoever. It is only Allah who knows that. It happened in one barrel. One man was killed from the Muslims. The Sahaba, they said, good news for him. Fil Jannah. Prophet ﷺ said, no, kalla. He's now being burned because of the piece of cloth he stolen from the booty. And they look for him and they find him that piece of cloth is in his special staff. He hired there. Nasallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was serving the Messenger of Allah. But this is what happened. Imagine if you deceive people's property. You borrow and you deny. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi. A lot of things happen with some Muslims. Wallahi, you grieve what some Muslims are doing. Wallahi, you grieve. Wallahi, you grieve what some Muslims are doing. It. Bad actions. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Some of them specialize in deception. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. From sin to a sin to a sin. Nas'Allah salam al-afiyah. How many women they were cheated by a man who tell them he married and he didn't marry? How many people who people borrow money from them? They don't pay them back. One brother, I wanted him to lend someone money. He said, he mentioned the number of money he borrowed, he lent people. And they didn't anything of it back. Not because they're not able. That's not an issue. If you borrow and you're not able, no blame on you. فَنَظِرَةٌ إِلَى مَيْسَرَةٌ. No blame on you if you borrow and you are not able at the deadline. Nothing is on you. Rather, Allah promised, inshallah, will pay on behalf of you. If you're sincere. You take in the means. مَنْ أَخَذَ أَمْوَالَ النَّاسِ يُرِيدُ أَدَّاءَهَا أَدَّى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. وَمَنْ أَخَذَ أَمْوَالَ النَّاسِ يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا أَتْلَفَهُ اللَّهُ. So the issue is not that you are not able to pay it back. But the issue is that you are sincere. You take in the means to pay people's property. This brother, how many thousands, hundreds of thousands, Muslims, they didn't pay him back. I remember a day, brother asking me, another time, I asked this brother to lend me money. Please talk to him on behalf of me. Okay, let me go. Please, this brother, he's this, help him. He said, okay, I have a question. Did it happen such time you borrow this money from me? He said, yes. You were supposed to bring it back that time, yes. That time passed, yes. Did you ever come to me? Even at least tell me you couldn't? No. I feel ashamed I was there. Ya akhi, subhanallah. Brother, he borrowed money and he hang on the phone on the one, whenever the brother called him, he hang the phone on him. It's not one individual, it's not two, it's not three, it's not four. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. La. We have to fear Allah Azza wa Jal. We have to fear Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Especially in the case of someone who is nice to us. Someone who sacrificed this time, someone to lend you his money, not charging you one extra cent because it's a riba. He doing that qard hasan. And instead of paying ahead of time at least, or at least on the right time. And if you can't give an apology, I know this is the time we agree, but I can't. I'm trying, I'm looking for job, I'm doing, please. No, he is able. Hang the phone on. In a way, some brothers, when they want someone not to come back to them, they lend him money. So he doesn't ask them anything. هذا هو حقيقة. This is where some brothers are. They want somebody not to ask them, then lend him money. Because he will not bring bad, which means he will not come back. لا يجوز يا أخوان. This we are saying this to fear Allah. Those of us who are here, we human beings. We try not to wrong people. Give them their right as fully. If you are not able, apologize to them. Tell them, I promise you, on time. Even if he keep on calling you. Because maybe he may think you're able, but you are not paying. Always feel free to talk to him, to convince him. If you feel it's really very burdening, he's transgressing you, take to somebody else. Yes, I borrowed this money from him, but I'm not able. And he keep on bothering me. Naam, he will stop. But that, if not, that's not the case, give them people's property. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to suffice us. Wallahu alam wa sallallahu wa sallam nabiyyina Muhammad.